So this old two-story building that the second floor, the people using the second floor were leaving it, they were vacating it. And we found out about it, and so we went and asked, will you lend us the second floor? It belonged, the building belonged to the Catholic Diocese of El Paso. We went, spoke to the bishop and said, you know, will you lend it to us? And Lord and behold, he said yes. So from that group, five of us, we quit our jobs, we quit going to school, and five of us moved in, no funding, no nothing, sleeping on the floor. And the first task was to begin to walk the streets so that we could come to understand in 1978, who are the poor in El Paso? Who really are the poor? And we had no resources. We couldn't do anything for anybody because we ourselves were begging for food to survive. When we met people that had needs, we would refer them to organizations that we thought could help them. There were two shelters in 1978, and so when we met homeless people, we would send them to the shelters, and you can go there. But then something happened. We had a couple of the people that we referred to one of these two shelters come back and say to us, where you sent us, they will not help us. And so when we asked, why not? Then came the answer, porque no tenemos papeles, because we're undocumented. And we did not know that in 1978 in El Paso, Texas, the only two emergency shelters would not give you shelter if you were undocumented. And so we asked the question, in El Paso in 1978, who would God identify with? And the answer we came up with, God would identify with the undocumented, the immigrant. So we said, then maybe what we need to do is begin to offer them hospitality. And we did. Very low key, very word of mouth. The undocumented begun to arrive to spend nights. And 35 years later, over 125,000 people have stayed with us.